handling data in IBM SPSS statistics software, it is very useful to have an identification number, or ID variable, for each case. But what should you do when you do not have an ID variable? We are going to dive deeper into how to add a unique identifier in SPSS that will consecutively number each of your participants. I recommend always having some form of identifier for each of the cases in your dataset. Now, this can be an identifier that came with each individual, such as a medical records number. Or it can simply be a random number. As long as every case has a different number, then you have a unique identifier. When I'm working in Excel, adding an ID number is easy. I always do this before I import my data into SPSS, and I start by creating a new column. In the first row, I type 1, and then 2 and 3 so that Excel knows the pattern that I'm looking for. I select the range of cells and double-click on that little handle to fill in the rest of the numbers. If I wanted my identifier to always have at least 3-digit numbers, I would type 101, 102, 103, and then again, double-click to fill in the rest. How can you create a unique identifier variable that consecutively numbers each case in an SPSS dataset? Here I have imported my fictitious data into SPSS. Or perhaps I've been given a dataset, but in either case, I still do not have a unique identifier. Let's create one. Go to Transform, Compute Variable. I am going to call my new variable ID, short for identifier. I could call it code or identification or some other name if I chose. I like to label my variables as much as possible, so click on Type and Label. And we will label this as a random identification number. It is a numeric type. Click Continue. We will be using the built-in functions for this unique identifier variable. The function is located in the miscellaneous list, but you can find it even more quickly by clicking on All. The function is called $CASENUM, and it's right at the top. Whenever you use a function, you see the description in this box telling you what the function does and any arguments that are necessary to use it. In this case, all we need is the function itself. You can click and drag the function, but it's even faster to double-click the function to move it into the numeric expressions box. Now click OK. In Data View, we see this ID variable and the consecutively numbered cases. Great. But what if I want my case numbers to have 3 digits? In that case, I will use my function in a formula. Use the dialog recall box to return to compute variable. The previous function is still there. I can add 100 to all of my case numbers so that they will begin at 101. If you would like to do this technique using syntax, here is the SPSS code. Compute is the command. Name the variable ID equal $CASENUM period. Format the ID variable as F, which means that it is numeric, a width of 8 and 0 decimals, period. Execute runs the command. To make the cases start at 101 and add a variable label, I would change the syntax. This time, compute the variable ID2 and use the formula 100 plus CASENUM. Now the ID variables will begin at 101. This sets the format of my new ID variable to be numeric with a width of 8 and 0 decimals. I can set the variable label for ID 2 as random identification number, and execute runs the command. If I had left the variable name as ID without the 2, it would have overwritten the existing ID number with my new set of ID numbers.